awesome.
There's Dan.
Boss are down.
Pick up some sweet stuff.
Boss are down.
Ooh, look.
Standard. It's
standard
so
leather armor.
Standard and garbage and poopy.
The same armor that the warrior class gives you from the beginning.
Icky poopy. Icky nasty poopy.
Icky nasty poopy stuff. Is it really?
Don't
nasty?
Put it on.
I'm looking at it.
It's up. Its physical defense is better, but look at its weight versus the other stuff.
Rust, weight.
And the poison resistance on this shit is just so goddamn good that once we get into Blighttown, it will help us tremendariously.
All right. Now
there's nothing
going.
Over there.
None over here.
No, you gotta go back. I would use a homeward bone just to get back quick, hit the souls, and then you have to run back through the depths up
Homeward bone.
I'll give you a homeward bone.
Oh, shit, passed. Boom! Back to the bonfire.
All right, so the next step is going to be run back to the Firelink Shrine, and then we're going to want to head back to the blacksmith and upgrade our Uchigatanga.
And you want to buy the key that's supposed to open up the door back to unlock the sorcerer.
If you want sorcery.
Might as well free him. He's part of the...
Yeah, fuck it, dude. No, level up. Get that good pussy.
Dexterity?
She popped that right up to 30. Yeah.
30 dexterity.
That's going to help us so well, because it increases your cast speed, too.
Dexterity does?
Yeah.
Interesting.
With Pyromancer, especially. I watched a side-by-side. Yeah! Pyromancer casts a basic fireball attack. You can sprint through those guys and take out that guy.
Yeah.
I watched a side-by-side of a pyromancer with basic dexterity versus a pyromancer with soft cap dexterity, and the cast time was between a quarter of a second and half of a second less, which is significant when you're sitting there going, aim it, as opposed to going, pow! You know what I mean?
Yeah. Run! So we're going back to Firelink Shrine?
Yeah, we're going all the way back.
Firelink Shrine, here we go.
And then when we get there, we can pick up some more pyromancies. Also, we need to worry about our attunement.
Yep, you need to get another slot.
I think we start with 2, so we should be good.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know. You're still alive?
Because he's dodging them.
Stupid whore. Dying to like it.
You hear the news.
What is the news?
What's your favorite Resident Evil?
If you say
5 or 6, I will fucking punch you in the dick.
No, I like 4 and up.
4? You didn't like the old survival horror ones?
I liked Resident Evil Nemesis. Is one of my favorites.
Do you remember Resident Evil Remake for the GameCube? The absolutely awesome... extremely terrifying remake they made of the original game?
No.
You don't remember that?
No. The furthest one back I played was Resident Evil 3 Nemesis.
It is a fucking masterpiece. There are a lot of dudes here. It is a fucking masterpiece on par with... I don't know. But it's one of the coolest...
Yeah!
It's one of the coolest... It's the coolest Resident Evil game. Simply because it's such an awesome remake of the original game.
And your ass!
It built upon it so fucking well. And it's getting an HD remake.
All
it's right. Coming to all the old gen systems and the 360 PS3. It's coming to the Xbox One. It's coming to the PlayStation 4. Everybody's going to be able to play Remake. Woo. Everybody's going to be able to play Remake! If you have seen Remake, you will know why I'm, like, pants-shittingly happy about this. You're gonna get fucking effed in the A. Yeah! See that shield?
I hate that.
The fucking shield play in this game is so good. But anyways, back to jacking off about Remake. Remake!
Yeah, I don't know what the hype is about Remake.
You gotta, when you get done here, go on the YouTube and look up Remake. It'll change your life.
Because Remake just means that they just revamped, like, maybe graphics.
And put
it on a new gen system so it'd be compatible, and then there you go.
The Resident Evil Remake is a completely different game from the original Resident Evil. It takes the core concepts and expands upon them in insanely terrifying, awesome, like, mind-blowing ways. Right. It takes a game that you might have beaten a million times and been super familiar with and makes it so you're scared of it again. It makes it genuinely terrifying.
Oh, I see.
The zombies don't stay dead.
What?
There are zombies that sprint at you. There's all sorts of crazy shit like that. They completely remade the game and put it on the GameCube, and it was awesome, but it fucking sold like shit. Because Resident Evil 4 came out.
Yeah, that's
and
right.
Because not everybody was looking for a remake, but, like, I think the fact that they went from Resident Evil 6, which was a fucking debacle. What are you doing?
Shut your face.
We're so close. Don't die now. Anyways, the fact that they went from the complete debacle that was, you got a guy behind you, a live, living guy behind you.
He's alive.
The fact, well, he's undead. Shut up. Shut your goddamn mouth! The fact that they went from... Oh, that was so fucking lucky. The fact that they went from Resident Evil 6 back to what was is widely considered a masterpiece
Which way am I going?
The core game. What did you expect was going to happen?
Oh, God!
What are you even doing? It's two shitty hollows! You just fought a giant vagina demon! Kill them!
I'm having fun.
Kill them with fire! God! Oh, the bonfire before my fucking shit dies. Actually, talk to the... go up the stairs to the right.
No! And... bonfire!
Why?
Gotta get... Is this flashback?
You're walking up the stairs and buying skills.
Who cares?
To the left.
I know where
everything
he
you
is.
Own in a box, well, to the left.
Yeah. I have my... Pyromancy is a great swarm, so...
Keeps talking and talking and talking.
Oh, yeah.
I love that, like...
I share my spells with you.
It's weird, considering the way every other game has gone, but I love that to get the story in this game, you really have to listen to what everybody's telling you.
Yep.
Oh, really?
No. You were supposed to say no.
It doesn't matter.
Fringe. Yeah, I know. Undead or not, I only wish that I could have repaid you.
Talk to him again.
Oh, hello there. I'm pleased to see you safe. Oh, and if by chance I'm pleased to assist you by sharing...
Yes.
Now
you're wonderful.
You're supposed to answer no. If you say I'm cool with pyromancers, then you say yes, I want to buy shit from you.
Right.
And then you touch his winky.
Modify!
Yeah, we're going to dump a bunch of shit into this shit.
You want to now? Or you
want to? Yeah.
Well, let's see if there's anything in here you want.
Combustion is 500, so that's perfect.
Yep.
Fireball is, you know, upgraded.
We already
upgraded.
Have Fireball.
Oh, yeah, we do. I was thinking Fire Orb, the upgraded
Fire
one.
Orb, yes, yeah, upgraded.
Iron Flesh is good, but we don't need it right now.
Nope, don't need that.
All right, so we bought that.
Combustion.
Yeah, fucking
upgrade,
pop that shit
freaking.
Up.
And right, one more.
Pyromancy plus 3.
There you go, that'll help.
That only takes souls,
yep.
If I remember
which is
correctly.
Awesome, yeah.
Yeah. And that shit gets super powerful pretty quick.
All right. We're going to where?
We're going to the blacksmith. So back
yeah.
up to the up
yep.
the stairs
yep.
to the elevator
yep.
and then yep. fuck a ride in a pussy.
Oh yeah.
Hey,
here's a little stuff for you.
Yeah, talk to them.
Oh, my guests, I will be departing with them shortly. So
departing with them shortly.
I'm afraid I will be saying goodbyes. It was a pleasure.
You run into her later? Not the fat guys, the lady praying behind there.
Yeah.
All hollowed out after her fucking
what have we
companions
here?
Died.
You look all times are grim. The least you can do is look sharp.
And then you fucked her up.
You might scare her off for good.
Says yo, you can't
suck
scare
my
her
dick.
Off. And then you come
I'm
over
the chosen undead.
You come over here.
You should all actually be sucking my undead flesh boner right now.
You are undead as well.
And she's already
you
undead.
To fraternize.
She is undead, but she is still
no
human. She is not hollowed yet, like
yes.
we have at this point.
Well, we're not hollowed either.
Yeah, we are. Look at you.
We're dead.
You're
undead.
In the process of hollowing.
The urgency of our
but we're not hollowed. Hollowed is when they can't control themselves.
That's true, but there are different stages of hollification. Oh my god, did I just make a Bleach reference? No! No, I'm done!
Did I
nope! I'm fucking... No!
So that's all she says.
No, Bleach is for fucking idiots and fucking pussies.
Hey, you shut your face.
No, it's terrible.
Bleach is awesome.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
It's the same thing that the shows like that. No, shows like that are the motherfucking reason I hated Japan for about 6 years.
Well, what about Full Metal Alchemist?
Suck dick.
Full Metal Alchemist is awesome.
It's a show about a bunch of whiny emo little girls complaining about how sad they are.
What about Naruto?
Garbage.
Well, your face is garbage. I like all of this.
All that shonen shit is garbage.
I like it all.
It's garbage.
Suck it.
No, don't go that way. Don't go that way.
Don't do it. Don't do it.
No, don't approach them that way. You will drag all of them at once.
Well, you just don't know my tactics, do you? Why don't you watch and learn, young Padawan?
If you go from the front, it's much easier.
Young Padawan, watch and learn. Come on. Come on. Let me show you how it's done around here.
Young Padawan, you got taken to half health by two hollows.
I was messing around.
I don't believe you.
Now let me show you what you do with this guy. But you done killed the other guy. You're dead. Oh my god, now there's only one of them. Do a little roll away, target.
Yeah.
Come on. No, you want some. Yeah, you do. Yep, suck it. You're dead.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, okay.
So you can knock the shield away on the second hit.
Stop fucking around. You don't know my skills. All right? I know the tactics.
Pizza's delicious.
You don't.
The fact that you get the backstab on that guy every time is actually really impressive, honestly.
Yeah.
I gotta admit.
I got skills. I was just saying. I got skills.
You got me at like.
Now watch this. Oh, you're dead. Oh my god.
You got me at about 4 o'clock right now.
Yeah, about 4? You're getting more confident in my abilities now?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know what I'm referring to, right?
No.
It's a dick joke.
Oh, you were?
From 6 o'clock to fucking 12 o'clock. And you got me at about a four. About a four.
I'm gonna get you up to about 5.
A saggy, sweaty 4. No, 5 is going down.
Yeah, we're going down to the ground.
I don't want to go down to the ground.
Oh, shit, what he's using. What the fuck? Oh, he's using the golem armor.
No, he's yeah.
The stone armor or whatever.
So he has a strength of at least 50.
Wow. Can we just tell him to come on down?
Rest at bonfire?
Oh, yeah. Did you ever talk to the dude? We did it earlier, didn't we?
Did we?
I think so.
Yeah, fuck it.
Alright, down here we go.
If not, you run into him later after a giant Indiana Jones trap.
We're giving him the Fire Ember. Right?
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Magnificent.
Upgrade your weapons past +5.
Yep.
Alright, let's repair our equipment. Holy shit. Our equipment is fucked!
We have run through the majority of the game now.
Yeah, well, this is... Oh, wait, we're upgrading each Titanite now.
That's right.
Reinforced weapon? We only have one Titanite charge, so that's not going to go very far. We need one more.
Okay, so we're going to buy them then. They're 800 a piece.
Alrighty.
So what we need to do...
Just pop some souls. Killed.
Neither of us want to see you go.
Soul popping.
Booty popping.
What ring? You have one ring. Oh, you didn't want to put that one. You don't even have any more. Okay.
No, we don't have any decent rings yet.
What the frick is going on? Over here. And we have this.
Yep. Eventually we will get Havel's ring.
Yep, that'll be fantastic.
Well, okay.
Not necessarily for this build.
Let's see.
The Wolf Ring, however, which boosts poise, is extremely important for this build. Because if you don't have high poise from high armor...
Yeah, you need the poise from the ring, which gives you 40 straight from the ring.
It's actually really easy to get.
We're about to get that next.
Yeah, because we're going down from here.
Don't get yourself killed. Well, Neither of us want to see you go hollow.
No. We'd have to sidetrack to go get the ring. We'd have to go through the forest if you wanted to get the ring now.
Yeah, that's where we're going.
I thought we were going to Blighttown after this.
No, not yet.
Because we already beat fucking...
Well, I don't know what you need.
We can't go Blighttown. We gotta go on Curious.
What he said was we have to grind curatives for toxic and poison and such.
Toxic specifically.
But per the story, that will be the next place.
I'll be seeing you there.
Alright.
Be careful out there.
We're about to go die, so let's have some of it.
No, buy more. What do we need? Titanite shards?
Yes. But you don't have any more soul items unless you want to go fucking grind for souls.
We might be doing that here soon.
No more. Gone. I could buy two more, but you wouldn't be able to upgrade your weapon. So there's really no point in doing it. Alright, this should be fun and slow.
Good luck.
This guy has fucking a lot of health. And I'll show you how to do the business if I can survive long enough to do the business.
He's not too tough.
No, he's
not. Wow.
Oh, wow, I didn't get a chance to fucking heal.
Well, what did you expect? You were standing within his attack range.
I thought I wasn't.
Actually, take it for a second. I gotta wash all this pizza poo off my hand.
Nom, nom. Nom.
I hate this fucking stone thing.
Nom, 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 nom.
There's a bunch of them later on, dude.
Yeah, but you'll be so powered, it won't even matter.
I agree.
Right now, he's a pain in the dick.
Yeah, right now he's mini-boss status.
Yeah, he's definitely mini-boss. And I need my souls. So, get out of the way. Get my souls. And can't do anything about it. So, get my souls. Thank you.
Nice, get him, get him. Fuck around the pussy.
He does a lot of damage.
Yeah, I told you, he's really hard.
My stomach is so fucking full of pizza, I'm going to die.
I think I'm fucking blocked. Get out of the way! God damn it. And there's like this little debris around that fucking stops you from being able to move. You're up. Have fun.
When he jumps up like that, the best thing you can do is jump to where he was.
Wouldn't he just land right where he was if you're there?
No, because once he jumps, he has a specific arc.
Oh, I thought he just jumped straight up in the air. And
no, he doesn't like auto-track. You'd grab the souls, right?
That's what I thought he did, was auto-track. And yes, I grabbed the souls.
Look how fucking fast he is.
Just remember to stay on the side that's not his fucking weapon.
So I hit attack instead of dodge. And then I died again. Fuck.
Alright! So this is gonna be a die a lot video. Black bow of Ferris. Yeah, where do I get a larger bow? Like a more powerful string to bow.
Later in the game.
Because I see, like, people who don't use Pyromancer or whatever, that's what they use in the bow. It does, like, 150 or more damage.
Yep.
Massively powerful bow. Which would be awesome.
You know, we never attuned our combustion spell. No, don't worry about it now. Don't worry about it now. We need to take out this bitch, and then everything else stops until this guy dies.
Come on. Pretty.
He hits in like 270 degrees, so unless you're behind him, the best thing to do, instead of roll sideways, is to roll away.
You need to get in close.
I know you need to get
his body.
Well, you can do that, but if you're in mid-range, get away.
Stupid fucking debris everywhere. You can't roll and you get stuck.
Rolling is not what... Rolling is a death sentence if you're rolling sideways or back and you don't know for a fact you're rolling out of the line of fire. You know what I mean? The absolute best thing to do at any time is just get away from the attack. If you can get away from the attack, then you're nowhere near the attack. It can't hit you. You know what I mean? God damn it.
Oh, yeah, debris, man. You gotta take him down the steps. Get him out of this fucking get you stuck area.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
No, he does fucking track
in
midair.
I told you, he auto tracks. There you go, good spot. But he just jumps in the air and stops you from fucking being able to stay there. You don't want to stay on that side, because his range of slice on his right side is good, but he has no attack on the left side of his body.
Yeah, I got you.
You have to stay on that side. And his range doesn't so much over there. So if you stay right there, you can get him, but he jumps out of the way.
And that's going to miss me completely because of that.
Good, there, perfect spot. Keep going, keep going.
Yeah, oh, I'll lame it out.
Go, get him, get that bitch. Get over there. Roll, yeah. Yes! Get him! Yeah!
Fuck
him
with that pussy! That pussy!
He actually dropped that shit for you.
Yep.
I don't think he dropped Demon Titanite for me when I killed him.
I don't even remember what the fuck he does.
Drop something. Hell yeah, Titanite!
So at this point, and the main reason we came back here besides grinding curatives for the fucking thing is because we should be right on the cusp. Of being able to use the Uchi-ga-ga-ga-ga-ga.
Uchi-ga-ta-na.
The Uchi-ga-booty. Okay, I need three. Whoops. Motherfucker.
Do we plan on using the E-stock with him? As like a main dexterity weapon?
The who?
The E-stock.
The S-stick? Or S-stock?
Whatever you call it. I don't give a fuck.
Possibly. We're going to switch it up between a couple weapons.
You can just get that now.
I know. There's a couple you can. I think I have it already.
No, you don't. We didn't even run down in the area.
Oh, I'm thinking the side swords is what I was thinking.
Oh, okay.
We need to purchase three Titanites.
We only need two.
Reinforce weapons. Nope. Three. See?
Wow. It actually takes a lot for this thing.
Now we're at plus five. Now we can modify equipment. Ujigatana plus six with one large Titanite shard.
Which we picked up freaking in the tower, which is good, so do that.
Yep. Also, we're going to run to the Moonlight Butterfly and get the Divine Ember so we can have Divine Weapons.
Yes. We're going to the forest, so we might as well just do that.
Yep.
Like, we're going to beat half of the forest. And get the awesome ring that we need for poise.
Don't yes.
Get the Divine Ember and kill some shit. Get some curatives.
Everybody say goodbye to this fucking thing.
What thing? Oh, you mean the Drake Sword?
The Dracus Award.
Are we already past the damage?
144 plus 84. That comes out to 228.
All right, so we're past the damage value on the Drake Sword. Now we're switching over to Uchikatana. But we need to...
Oh, look at that.
Get some souls or something and get a repair box because that thing has ridiculously low weapon durability.
Oh,
so
does
that'd
it,
be
huh?
good to have on you. But we don't have any more souls yet. So when we come back from the forest, that's probably...
And the durability doesn't go up from the ship.
Nope.
Actually, I think kind of... it's 200, isn't it? Or 2,000.
Yeah, it's 2,000 per box. Which we only have 1,000. So we'll come back and
get We already bought the repair box.
Did we?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah.
We're good. Let's go.
Crest of Artorias.
Artorias. And if we didn't get the, like, for people who like the mid-sized strength build type weapons like Claymore,
mm-hmm.
if you didn't pick that up because the...
we're going to put away
the
some
the Hellkite Dragon weapons. Was guarding it. You can just pick up the Bastard Sword from him. It's kind of the same thing.
We're going to keep the Drake Sword just in case we need it for some reason. Get rid of the claim. No, we're keeping that. Get rid of that. Get rid of the hand axe. We started with a hand axe.
Fuck shit up with that hand axe.
Yeah, we did pretty good with the hand axe, but...
We have two great axes. And there's the Dragon King axe, which I just
nice.
Got from that boss.
Beautiful saw.
Spear.
You get a... From the first mimic you run into in the game, you get a lightning spear.
Really?
Which helps out a lot later on.
Lightning spear.
Yeah, and then you can get the achievement if you're worried about the achievements because you can just upgrade the lightning spear because it's already at lightning, so it was already a plus 10 spear that's been upgraded.
Ah.
So happy day.
So how do you
Halberd is my
start spear. Adding lightning to your weapons because I want to do that with my
you have to
winger.
You have to get the ember. You have to get the lightning ember from I don't know where yet. And then you use that to upgrade it.
Yeah.
Well, we have a talisman for curatives.
Yeah.
Oh, because we picked one up. Well,
yeah, you automatically
get
one in the beginning. We need to attune our combustion.
I agree. Keep the spider shield in case we want to try it. Okay. We're just getting shit out of the inventory in case for some reason I need to switch between shit in the actual inventory.
In the
keeping the tattered set. Yep. Because I've actually had to do that. And the one time I beat, or the first time I beat the Iron Golem, I was using the Lightning Spear on him because he's weak to lightning, but it wasn't doing nearly as much damage as my Zweihander. So I had to, in the middle of the fight, stagger him with the fucking spear to where he was down for 6 seconds, and then frantically jump into my fucking inventory and manually switch out weapons.
Why you just put it on as a sub-weapon?
Because I didn't want the weight.
So you fucked yourself.
I didn't fuck myself.
Hollow thief.
Fang Boar Helm.
See, you have it, and you'll never use it.
Get rid of that. That's never getting fucking used.
For the people who are doing, actually, it's really if you really want to or not. Depends on what kind of build you want. But that Ring of Favor adds plus 20% to your health, endurance, and what was the other one? Something else. But once you put
health,
on,
endurance, and weight.
Weight, yes. So it's really good in the beginning of the game, even throughout the rest of the game. I want to
see
it,
how much damage this does, man.
But once you put it on, you cannot take it off.
Oh, wow, that's so fucking fast.
It will break. So
wow, I fucked that right up.
Just make your decisions wisely.
That actually, the fact that it breaks tells you a lot about the actual character in the game. And if you don't know what I'm, like, referring to, What is it? Vadi Vidya has an awesome, does a lot of awesome lore videos about Dark Souls on YouTube, and he will explain in depth kind of like where his character is coming from and why he's such a dickbag, but yeah. No, it is explained very well. So this thing already does more damage than the Dragon Sword.
Did you attune combustion?
No, I didn't. God damn it.
Go to tune!
I wanted to try the poopy poop.
A two.
See, look, we do have two, so.
Nice. Yeah, because we started out as a Pyromancer class, right?
Yep.
That's why.
Or no, wait, do we have two?
Yes, go.
Look.
Stop. Watch. Now press over. Stop. Go back. Get out of there. Whatever that is. Now just press over.
Ah, there we go. I got it.
See, now go to select combustion. Bam.
Shut up!
Yeah, you fucking noob.
I'm tired of your bullshit, lady. So there's the super close fart lighting attack. It does a very good amount of damage. However, we will be sticking with fireballs. Actually, combustion would probably be pretty good in this area that we're going to. Because we are now going to the...
You don't even need it because it's yours.
That's true. We are going to the Darktoot Forest.
Well, yeah, combustion
would be... Boo! Say what?
Combustion would be good.
Yeah. Look at how pretty this is. We're gonna figure out if my brightness settings are right on the fucking video now. Okay, so there's these motherfuckers
here. It's a tree! Smack, smack.
Oh my god, we take so little, like, stamina damage from their fucking whip attack. Even my heavy guy takes a little more stamina damage than that from their whip attacks. Alright, there's the way to the Darkroot Basin, which we'll be going to eventually later.
Yeah.
Do I have enough room for a quick attack? Yes, I do, and it's a fucking one hit. I love it, and it's a stab. Pow, pow.
What kind of attack is that?
That's just the heavy, the one-handed heavy.
Yeah.
That's fucking amazing, actually.
Mm-hmm. Jump for the trap. Oh, you did.
So he down. And damn it, I didn't have the shit up in time.
Can't backstab trees.
I know, but I wasn't trying to backstab him. I was trying to get the shield up. Okay, so these guys have a very high drop rate on a very important item, which is the blooming purple moss clump. Now, the reason this is so important is because it cures toxic. Now, there are two ways to get poisoned in this game. One is through regular poison buildup, which can be easily cured, through regular purple moss clumps, you can actually build up a resistance to it through your items and through building up your actual resistance. But then there is toxic, which is basically instant poison that you cannot defend against. If you get hit with something that turns you toxic, you are immediately toxic. And yep. There's not a damn thing you can do about it, and it sucks.
Trying to read a message?
There is a fucking bonfire back there.
Yep.
Can I...
No, you don't know how to get to it? Go. Get out of the cliff.
Okay.
Go to the left. See that little wall? Smack it.
Oh, are you fucking kidding me?
Yep.
Oh my god!
Learn something new every day.
Oh my god!
I would definitely probably,
leave a sign.
No, can't know that one, because we come through this area a lot. Especially if you're gonna farm for curatives.
Objects. Yeah, I completely agree, actually.
Not to mention...
Do you think it would be environment? It would be environment.
Not to mention with the golems, you're probably going to die and it would suck, have to keep running all the way fuck back to you.
No, the giants are easy for me, dude. Look at the leg! It's happening again! Our pyromancer is possessed by the devil! The fucking devil is all in the fucking shit! I can't believe... Now please subscribe to my channel. Here we do full playthroughs of some of our favorite and most hated games. We do cool one-offs like Complete Idiots Play and Spoiler Alert. And every now and then, you can catch us on the weekends for some awesome multiplayer games with our best friends, the Wonder Pets. I hope you guys like all the new episodes we have coming out every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Please subscribe so that you can check out all the new content as it comes out. And we'll see you next time.